Dr. R. Sugarat Samuel is working as professor in physics in SRM University, Chennai. He is also training students for IIT JEE, AIEEE and BITSAT. He has more than 16 years of academic experience both in teaching and research. He has published a book titled The Complete Handbook of Bachelor of Electronic Science Practicals. It is prescribed book in the syllabus for BSE Electronic Science by University of Madras. He has attended and presented papers in several national and international conferences and conducted many training programs and workshops. He has experience in both regular classroom teaching and also online teaching. His research areas are ultrasonics, polymers, crystal growth, and photovoltaic systems.
Welcome to UGC lecture series on Applied Sciences Electronics. We have been listening to a series of lectures on the subject Electricity and Basic Electronics for the BSc Electronic Sciences degree program. This paper is the first paper in the semester 1. This lecture is the 41st lecture in the series. In today's lecture, we are going to see the following topics. Let us see the session outline for today's lecture. In this session, we are going to see the regions of the output characteristics, namely saturation, cutoff, and active regions, and also how to use transistor as a device like a switch and an amplifier. This session is a very important session as far as the application part of the transistor is concerned. In the earlier lecture, we have learned elaborately about the output characteristics of a transistor. We have taken an NPN transistor in the common emitter, that is CE mode, and studied the input characteristics and output characteristics of the transistor. What is the application of studying these characteristics? We can use it for different purposes. In this lecture, we are going to see the very purpose of such a study. Let us start this lecture with the consideration of different regions in the output characteristics graph. In the last lecture, I have given a small introduction for the different regions, the existence of different regions in an output characteristics curve. Based on the necessity, we can operate the transistor in a particular region. What are the regions? Let us have a look at them. In the output characteristics of a transistor, three regions can be identified. They are saturation region, cutoff region, and active region. This is how we can identify the three regions. In the diagram, this color, the gray color region, is called the saturation region, and it is marked here. And the green color region here is the active region, and the pink color, which is marked very close to the VCC line, is called the cutoff region. And here it is just earmarked, and what are the importance of these regions is understood here. In saturation region, the region is very close to the current line, and it covers the area where the knee voltage occurs for the different values of IB. In the last lecture, I have mentioned what is the knee voltage. It is a point, it is the region, or it is a point where the IC current reaches the saturation. So, that particular point is called knee point. So, saturation region is found in that area. And cutoff region is the region which is very close to the VCE line, that is the x-axis, and it is considered below the IB equal to 0 line. When we have no input current in the transistor, in that condition also there is a collector current due to the biasing part. So, that is marked here. Below that is called cutoff region, and in between is called active region. we can operate the transistor in these three regions based on the application. First, let us see what is saturation region. We have already seen the region where the saturation of the current occurs. So, let us consider technically what is that region. The initial part of the curve is called the saturation region. The region is between the origin and the knee point. The knee point is the point where the IC is about to become constant. Why it is here mentioned as the initial part of the curve? When we plot the graph for a particular IB, it starts from 0, the IC starts from 0 and started growing to a high value and reaches a saturation. So, that is why it is marked as the initial part. Cutoff region. There is a very small collector current in the transistor even when the base current is 0. In the output characteristics, the region below the curve for IB is equal to 0 is called cutoff region. Below the cutoff region, the transistor does not function. Now, we have to see what is the active region which covers the large area in the output characteristics curve. Let us see what is active region. The central region of the curves is called active region. In the active region, the curves are uniform. In this region, the emitter base junction is forward biased and the collector base junction is reverse biased. For using the transistor as an amplifier, we will use the active region. As I have already mentioned, we can operate the transistor in any of these three regions, namely saturation region, cutoff region, and active region. For different purposes, we operate the transistor in the different regions. What is the use of the saturation region and cutoff region? Can a transistor be useful in those regions? But below the cutoff region, the transistor is in the off mode. It will not function because there is no input current at all. IB is 0. So, it is not active. It is not working. Even if a transistor is not working, is it of worth application? Is it having any worthy application even if the transistor is in the off mode? It is actually very much useful as far as the transistor application is concerned. The saturation region, the transistor is conducting to the maximum. The current is reached, it has already reached a maximum value. The IC reaches a maximum value. So, in that region also, a transistor could be used. The cutoff region is the off mode of a transistor and the saturation region is the on mode of a transistor. So, we can operate a transistor as a switch between these two regions, in the two different regions. We have to skip the active region and use the transistor in the cutoff and the saturation region. In that situation, a transistor behaves as a switch. And if it is operated in the active region, the transistor has an application for amplifier. Let us see what are the two applications of the transistor. Transistor as a device. The transistor can be used as a device for application depending on certain factors. The first factor is the configuration. Which configuration it is used, like common base configuration, common collector configuration and common emitter of configuration. The second point is the biasing of emitter base and collector base junctions. And the third point is operation region, namely the saturation, cutoff and active region. Now, we shall discuss the characteristics of CB and CE mode in later sessions. We will reserve it for comparison among the three modes of operation. So, we are not going to touch upon CB and CC modes. But the biasing of emitter base and collector base junctions and the operation region, these two could be right now used for making use of the transistor for different applications. How a transistor could be used as a device? In the characteristic circuit, we have just connected the biasing EMF sources and maybe if you meet us like ammeter, voltmeter on the input side and the output side for measuring the values. But we have not connected any active components like resistors. So, the transistor could be used as a device when we connect an input along with the biasing and also a resistor on the output side for taking the voltage out, the potential out. We need to connect a resistor. When we add these components, the transistor is now called as an active characteristic circuit. So, in that condition, we have to study the characteristics. When we don't connect the active components, the transistor is said to be a static characteristic circuit. But when we connect these additional components for the application, the circuit is called a dynamic or active transistor circuit. So, let us have a look at the circuit. Let us try to understand how it could be used as an active device. Now, we are confined to the operation of a transistor only in the CE mode. Hence, we will now concentrate on the biasing and the operation region to understand the working of transistor as a device. Basically, a transistor can be used as two important devices based on the regions of its operation. The first device is a switch and the second device is an amplifier. What is a switch? It should have two states like on and off, high or low, whatever it is. As I have just now mentioned, the saturation and cutoff regions are of much use as far as a switch operation of switching operation of an amplifier is concerned. Let us have a look at the operations of the transistor in the different regions. As a switch, when we use transistor, it is used in the cutoff and saturation regions and the transistor acts as a switch. On the other hand, if it is operated in the active region, it can be used as an amplifier. Let us see the circuit diagram in which a transistor is used as a device. Now, to make the transistor work as a device, we need to connect the active components like resistors. How these resistors and the input voltage are given, how they are connected to the circuit, let's have a look at the circuit after a short break. Welcome back. Now, it's time for us to see the active circuit for a transistor to be used as a device. Let us have a look at the circuit diagram. Now, this is a modified circuit for making use of the transistor as a device. When we look at this diagram, the biasing voltage VBB and another biasing voltage VCC on the input and output sides respectively are still intact in the circuit. But additionally, we have this RC. It is called the collector resistance. It is additionally connected so that across which we can take the voltage as the output. And here one resistor is connected. This is RB, the base resistance. And these make the circuit as a dynamic circuit. And the input VI is given here. And it is different from this VBB which is connected here. The VBB was also acting as the input in the previous circuit, but now in the modified circuit we have an additional VI source. It could be a DC voltage or it could be an AC voltage depending on the use. This circuit could be analyzed for the transistor acting as a device. The two devices we have mentioned, one device is the switch, the other device is amplifier. These two we are going to discuss in the lectures. Let's see how much we could cover in this lecture. Now, let's start our discussion with the device called switch, how a transistor is used as a switch. For that, we need to analyze the circuit with the help of the laws which we have already learnt, Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law. Those laws we have to apply for these circuits and analyze how it is acting as a switch. Let's continue to see the analysis part of this circuit. When we apply the Kirchhoff's voltage rule to the input side and the output side of this circuit, these are the two equations we could deduce. The first equation is for the input side, which is VBB is equal to IBRB plus VBE. Similarly, for the output side, it is VCE is equal to VCC minus ICRC. When we look at the diagram, I hope we could have a better understanding of these two equations. Let's quickly have a look at the diagram. VBB, and this is IBRB, potential drop, and also there is a potential drop VBE, that is across the junction. So this is one loop. For this loop, the Kirchhoff's law is written. Similarly, here we have another loop. Here it is VCC is the potential source, ICRC is the potential drop across the collector resistance, and another potential is across this junction VCE. So these three factors form the equation for this loop. So that is what is written here. This minus sign is based on the sign convention normally we consider. We shall treat the VBB as the DC input, VI here, and VCC, VCE as the DC output voltage VO. So let us incorporate these notations. VBB is VI and VCE is VO, output, input and output voltages respectively. We have not done anything else, but we have just used these new notations as the input voltage and output voltage here. Now, let's see how the VO changes as VI increases from 0 onwards. In the case of silicon transistor, as long as the input VI is less than 0.6, the transistor will be in the cutoff state and the current IC will be 0. So, in this equation, the previous equation, IC is 0 if the VBB is less than 0.6. So, we have VO as VCC itself. When VI becomes greater than 0.6 volt, the transistor is in active state with some current IC in the output path and the output voltage VO decreases as the term ICRC increases. With the increase of VI, IC increases almost linearly, and so the output voltage VO decreases linearly till its value becomes less than about 1 volt. After that, what happens when we consider the increasing trend of the input voltage? What will happen further? Let's have a look at the effects. Beyond this, the change becomes nonlinear. The transistor goes into the saturation state. With further increase in VI, the output voltage is found to decrease further towards 0, though it may never become 0. If we plot the VO versus VI, that is the output voltage versus the input voltage as a curve, we see that between the cutoff state and active state, and also between the active state and saturation state, there are regions of non-linearity showing that the transition from cutoff state to active state and from active state to saturation state are not sharply defined. This concept we will be able to easily understand when we look at the picture. This is how it appears, the cutoff region, and then in the cutoff region, the VCE is almost steady up to a particular range. And similarly, in the saturation region also, the VCE output is steady. But in between, in the active region, it is varying sharp, though it is not that much sharp, but it is varying. But what is the importance of these two values. Here the VCE is high and here the VCE is very low. Here the VCE is output voltage, that we should keep in mind. But that is governed by the VBE. Here VBE is the input voltage. So when the input voltage is very high, VCE is very high. Similarly, when the input voltage is very high, the output voltage VCE is very low. What does this imply? We can govern the output voltage, either VO or VCE, both are one and the same in this case, by the input voltage, that is VBE, which is also called as VI in this case. So, by varying the input voltage, we have a control over the output voltage. That is what is understood from the graph we have drawn. And moreover, one thing we should remember, when the input voltage is very low, the output voltage is very high. And the reverse, when the input voltage is very high, the output voltage is very low. And the transition is happening in between. So, if we neglect the transition region, here it is marked as the active region, the change that is happening between the two regions. In the extreme conditions, when we operate the transistor, it is very well acting as a switch because it has got the two extreme values of the output voltage. Let's have a look at the diagram once again. Have a look at this. This is one definite value of VCE. After that, there is a change, but nevertheless, we need not mind the change. But what is the lowest value? Lowest value is also there, and here it is almost steady. So, there are two steady values of the output, which is very much governed by the input voltage. So, these are the two states of a switch. If we are able to reduce the transition part, if we make that transition very sharp, then we will be able to have a control over the switch. We will be able to effectively use the transistor as a switch. These are the two states, on and off. Let's technically see how this is on and off, what happens to the current and what happens to the voltage in the two states. As long as VI is low and unable to forward bias the transistor, VO is high, that is at VCC. If VI is high enough to drive the transistor into saturation, then VI is low, very near to, VO is low, very near to zero. When the transistor is not conducting, it is said to be switched off, and when it is driven to the saturation, it is said to be switched on. So, these are the two points we need to keep in mind. In the saturation region, the transistor is in the on state, and in the cutoff region, the transistor is in the off state. These points we have to keep in mind. Let's have a look at the characteristics curve once again and keep the two points strongly in our mind. In the saturation region, it is in the on state because the voltage is low but the current is high, and in the cutoff region, it is said to be off, but the current will be very low in the off region. When the transistor conducts current, then only it is said to be on. So, this point we have to keep in mind. It is not based on the voltage we say the on and off, but it is based on the current we say the transistor is on and off, because it is the reverse part, that's why the thing is to be registered very well in our minds. Now, we have seen one application of the transistor, that is the switch. Let's quickly see what is a switch. The transistor is used in the saturation and cutoff region only. In those two states, the switch has got the on and off states. What about the application of the transistor in the active region? In the case that we have taken right now, the active region was just called as a transition region, which we have not highlighted very much, which is actually not required. The transition stage is to be very much reduced as far as the switching operation of a transistor is concerned. We have not given much importance to the transition that is happening between the saturation and the cutoff. But In the active region, can a transistor be used? As we have seen in the beginning of the lecture, in the active region also, a transistor has an application that is called the amplifier. In the active region, transistor will be used as an amplifier. How the transistor could be operated in the active region to make it work as an amplifier? First, we should know what is an amplifier. An amplifier is the one which has an input and an output, and the output is to be enhanced by the amplifier. For making the enhancement, we need to supply some energy. So, that is the operation of an amplifier. We will see how an amplifier is done, how an amplification is done using a transistor in the subsequent lectures. Now, we have come to the end of this lecture. We will see what is the topic, what are the topics we have seen in today's lecture. So, it's time for us to have a quick review of what we have learnt today. This is the session summary. In this session, we have seen the different regions of the output characteristics curve, namely saturation, cutoff, and active regions, and also the application part of transistor as a device. One device we have seen, it is called the switch, and we have reserved the second application, that is the amplifier, for the subsequent lecture. Let's test our understanding by answering these questions. What are the different regions in the output characteristics of a transistor and explain them? Explain how a transistor is used as a switch. We will learn about the other application, namely the amplifier, in the next lecture. With this, I wind up today's lecture. Thank you.